This recording demonstrates how to configure the new ECS 2.0 in few minutes. Previous versions of ECS were managed by the ViPR controller, but ECS 2.0 is now managed by its own UI or API. The first component to configure is called a storage pool. It allows an administrator to provide physical separation of data if needed. Generally, a single storage pool will be created on each data center. Then, a virtual data center must be created. A VDC Access Key is generated by each VDC to allow an administrator to federate several VDCs together. A replication group can now be created to define how the data will be replicated amongst several VDCs. If you have several VDCs, you can create a replication group with only one VDC, another one with two VDCs, and another one with all the VDCs, for example. An authentication provider can be configured to integrate ECS with an external LDAP or Active Directory, but this is optional. ECS provides multi-tenancy by using namespaces. When a namespace is created, a namespace admin is assigned to it, and a default replication group must be selected. ECS 2.0 introduces new features that can be activated at the namespace level. Hard and soft quota to limit the storage that can be consumed. Retention policies that provides warm capabilities. To start using one of the object APIs supported by ECS, Amazon S3, OpenStack Swift, Atmos REST, or Centera CAS, a user must be created and associated with a namespace. S3 browser can now be configured to use ECS to store retrieve data through the Amazon S3 API. Finally, the ECS UI can be used to create a bucket. Quota and retention policies can also be set at this level. File system can be enabled to access the data through HDFS, but ECS 2.0 also introduces a new feature to allow access during outage. When enabled, a bucket can still be accessed read-write when the different VDCs aren't able to communicate together. It can be during a temporary site failure or network outage. A file can be uploaded through S3 browser using the Amazon S3 multipart upload feature. ECS 2.0 also provides advanced monitoring capabilities. For example, it's now possible to display metering information at the namespace or bucket level. It includes information about the capacity used, the number of operations, and the traffic.